So hello friends, this is Jairaj welcoming you all to this second session on unit 3 of hydraulics and pneumatics, that is flow through pipes. So in our yesterday's class, that is session 1, we have seen a brief introduction of fluid flow through a confined section, that is pipe. So and in this class, so we'll be extending our discussion along the flow through pipes. So in this class we will be discussing numerical examples on Chezy's equation. Yesterday we have discussed numerical examples on Darcy's equation, Darcy-Weisbach equation. Now we'll see the Chezy's part of it, and next we'll be moving on our discussion to minor losses. Yesterday we have seen the major losses. So when the length of the pipe is considerably higher, there are two major kinds of losses, that is one is major loss and minor losses. That is when length of the pipe is larger. So major losses are because of friction, and minor losses, those losses which can be neglected because the length of the pipe is higher. So those losses we have will be seeing it today. So we have seen yesterday also, we will be seeing it in detail in this class. And on the minor losses, we'll be seeing few numerical examples on them combined with the major and minor losses. And finally, we'll be concluding our class with hydraulic and total gradient line. So as a brief recap of yesterday's class, so yesterday we have seen the fluid flow, type of fluid flow. Yesterday we learned that fluid flow occurs in an open channel as well as in a closed, that is a confined channel. It may be a pipe or duct, whatever. So during the flow of pipe, because of change in velocities, the pipe flow can be classified as laminar flow and turbulent flow. Laminar flow is a flow where the molecules of the fluid are arranged in a regular manner. They flow in a regular manner without any disturbances or eddies. Whereas in a turbulent flow, the molecules are random. They do not move in any order. This leads to causes of eddies because of higher velocities. Because of these eddies, the molecules try to transfer momentum and energy within each other, leading to higher friction, thereby leading to higher losses. In real life application, most of the fluid flow is turbulent in nature, and what are all the flow conditions that we discuss in this chapter will all be the turbulent flows. So depending on the type of flow, we have seen there were the fluid loses its energy during the course of flow through the pipe. So when the pipe length is sufficiently larger, we have classified the losses into two types, that is one is major loss and one is minor loss. Major losses, which has to be given consideration, enough consideration, those losses are classified as major losses. And in the major losses, we have seen losses occurring because of friction only. So we have assumed that the pipe length is sufficiently longer, hence the loss due to friction will be the major factor which affects the reduction of energy. They are classified under major losses. And minor losses are those losses which can be neglected compared to the length of the pipe. So which will get nullified over the flow of fluid over a considerable length of the pipe. So minor losses are because of sudden expansion of the pipe, sudden contraction of the pipe, due to bend in a pipe or any pipe fittings. Yesterday we have seen what are the different kinds of pipe fitting. So and we'll be discussing this down the line in today's class. And due to obstruction in a pipe. So the pipe, during the flow in a pipe, the flow may be obstructed by any foreign element or blockage within a pipe. So those are dealt under obstruction in the pipe flow. So all these are minor losses because the length of the pipe is very larger. Hence they get nullified over a period of time during the flow. So to discuss the major energy losses or to empirically find out the major energy losses, we have seen two types of equations. One is Darcy-Weisbach equation and another one is Chezy's equation. So yesterday we have seen the Darcy-Weisbach equation. So there the head loss because of friction, HF is head loss due to friction, is calculated by 4FLV² / 2GD, where F is the friction factor. It depends on number of parameters, depending on the type of pipe surface,
etc. So FLV square by 2GD. So the friction factor is a function of Reynolds number. So we have seen the Reynolds number, we have seen yesterday, it is ratio of inertia force by viscous force. When the Reynolds number is less than 2000, we have seen Reynolds number is a dimensionless number. When the Reynolds number is less than 2000, so we can calculate the friction factor using the relation F is equal to 16 by R. So next, when the Reynolds number is 4000, that is up to 10^6, that is the flow is turbulent in nature, then we can calculate the friction factor as F equal to 0.079 by R power 1/4. So next, we have seen Chezy's equation. So Antonio D. Chezy, a French engineer, has formulated an equation in order to calculate the head loss occurring because of friction in a pipe. So which is equal to V equal to C into root of M into I, where V is the velocity of the flow in a pipe, C is Chezy's constant. We have seen yesterday it depends on the type of the pipe, flow, surface, etc., and various other conditions, into root of M into I. I is head loss per unit length of the pipe, and M is hydraulic main depth, that is D divided by 4. We have seen this for a circular pipe. So for various other cross sections, we have seen for rectangular cross section or an elliptical cross section, the mean diameter, that is an equivalent diameter that is equivalent to the circle, can be found out using the relation. So in this class, we'll be seeing few numerical examples on Chezy's equation. So we have to remember Chezy's equation is V equal to C into root of M into I. C is the Chezy's constant, V is the velocity of flow in meters per second, M equal to D by 4, that is hydraulic mean depth, D is the diameter of the pipe, and I is given by the relation HF divided by L, that is head loss per unit length. So with this basic understanding, let us move on to a few numerical examples on Chezy's equation. This worked example 4. So find the head loss due to friction in a pipe of diameter 300 millimeters and length equal to 50 meters through which the water is flowing at a velocity of 3 meters per second using Chezy's formula. So take C equal to 60. So it has been directly given here. So we have to find the head loss due to friction. So that is the major loss. So we have to find the head loss due to friction in a pipe of diameter 300 millimeters. The diameter is 300 millimeters. We have to consider flow through a pipe. Fluid is flowing through a pipe of diameter 300 millimeters, and the length of the pipe is 50 millimeters. The length of the pipe is 50 millimeters. So these are the given data through which the water is flowing at a speed velocity of 3 meters per second. The velocity is given here. The velocity is equal to 3 meters per second. So using Chezy's formula, we have to find out head loss due to friction. So let us just tabulate what are the given data within this problem. So the diameter of the pipe is given, that is D equal to 0.3 meters. So I have converted this 300 millimeters into meters. The length of the pipe is 50 meters. It is directly given. Chezy's constant is 60. So, and V equal to 3 meters per second, that is velocity of flow within a pipe. The Chezy's equation is given by loss of it by Chezy's equation is given by V equal to C into root of M into I. V is velocity of flow, it is directly given, and C is the Chezy's constant, directly given, and M into I, M can be found out using the relation D by 4, and I is nothing but HF divided by L. So we have to, in this formula, we have to calculate I, and later from I, we can calculate the HF, that is loss of head because of friction. So first let us try to find out M equal to D by 4, that is hydraulic mean depth. So that is the diameter is 0.3 meters divided by 4, that will sum up to 0.075 meters. So next, let us substitute all this data into the Chezy's equation. V is equal to C into root of M into I. So we have seen the velocity is 3 meters per second, and Chezy's constant is 60 into root of M. So M, we have calculated it here just now. That is 0.075. So 0.075 I. So we are calculating the I here. So I comes up to 0.033 per unit head loss per unit length. So from I, I'll be able to find out the head loss because of friction. So by the formula I equal to HF divided by L, I is given, head loss by friction is given by the formula I equal to HF divided by L. Cross multiplying I can get HF value. So I'll substitute 0.0333, the I value equal to HF divided by the length. Length is 50 meter. So from this equation I'll be able to easily find out what is the head loss because of friction. Head loss because for friction according to Chezy's formula is 1.665 meters. So if the same problem is done with Darcy's equation, it will give a different value of HF, which will agree very closely, though they are not same. Yerdu ondalladhe idru kuda Darcy's equation nallu kuda ee problem na solve madabodu. Darcy's coefficient namge gottirbeku. So Darcy's coefficient F na find out madkondo naavu ide problem na Darcy-Weisbach equation alli maadabodu. So where HF equal to 4FLV square by 2GD. So all the data except F is given. F na neevu find out maadkolabodu. So F na find out maadkondi. F gottagide namge given anta heladre. We can find out HF using Darcy equation also. So eradu kuda hattiradalli it will resemble or match each other. Though they are not equal. Eradu sama barodilla, but they will be in close agreement with 5 to 10% of accuracy. So next work example, find the diameter of a pipe of length 2000 meters when the rate of flow of water through the pipe is 200 liters per second and the head loss due to friction is 4 meters. Take the Chezy's constant as C equal to 50. So here a different problem slightly. So here we have to find the diameter of the pipe. So in the previous example, we found out the head loss by friction, that is HF. So in this case, we will find out the diameter of the pipe and rest all the data are given. So find the diameter of the pipe. So the diameter of the pipe is not known. We have to find it. So the length of the pipe is given. It is 2000 meters. Rate of flow of water through the pipe, that is Q, discharge is given 200 liters per second. And the head loss due to friction is given directly. HF is given. HF equal to 4 meters. Sorry. So it is 4 meters. And Chezy's constant is given. C equal to 50. So with this basic details, so we'll be able to calculate the diameter of the pipe very easily using Chezy's equation. So let us see what are all the given data. L is 2000. Length of the pipe is 2000 meters. Q discharge is 200 liters per second. So we have to convert this into meter cubes per second. So very easy, divided this by 1000. So the liters per second will get converted into meter cubes per second. So next, Chezy's constant C equal to 50 and HF, that is head loss due to friction, is 4 meters given directly. So we know that loss of head given by Chezy's equation is V equal to C into root of M into I. So here we do not have V, velocity directly namge kottilla. So naave en maadbeku, we can calculate this V using Q. So we know that Q is equal to A into V, so area into velocity. So area beku andre namge, so we must know the diameter of the pipe. So diameter of the pipe is unknown in order to find out the velocity also, whereas the other details like C, Chezy's constant is given, M is hydraulic mean depth given by D by 4, D matte gottilla namge, so we can directly put M as D by 4, and I is HF divided by L, that is head lost per unit length. So head lost per unit length can be find out. I equal to HF, HF is given, L is given, so HF by 4, HF by L will give us I directly, C is given, so velocity has to be found out from Q and M has to be found out using the diameter of the pipe. So let us move to the solution part of the problem with this basic details. So as we have discussed here, we have to find the velocity. So we have to find the velocity here. Velocity namge ee problem nalli gottilla. So velocity na naavu Q indane kandidiyak sadhya, discharge inda. So discharge is given by the relation area into velocity. So continuity equation. So velocity cross multiply, when we cross multiply we get V equal to Q divided by area. Area is found out by pi by 4 d square formula. Q is 200 liters anta heli kottidara, idanna naavu meter cubes ke convert, meter cubes per second ke convert madidivi, that is 0.2 meter cubes per second divided by the area. We do not know the value of d here, so hence we'll leave the equation as it is, and then m hydraulic mean depth is equal to d by 4. Illu kuda namge d gotilla, we'll substitute the value of m as it is in the equation. Illi iruva hagene navu d by 4 ne direct aagi nama equation alli naviga substitute martta idivi. So observe here, I equal to hf by l, so this is given completely. So hf is nothing but head loss due to friction, and l is the length of the pipe, 2000 meters. So calculate madadaga we get 0.002 meters per, sorry, the head loss per unit length of the pipe. So next, substituting all these details in the Chezy's equation, where V is given by, V is equal to C into root of M into I is the Chezy's formula. So in this equation, we are substituting the value of V directly from, we are substituting the value of V directly from here. This is the value of V. So that is Q by A, 0.2 by pi by 4 d square. Hage substitute maditini. Next, Chezy's constant 50 directly given in the problem. Next, root of M into I. So M directly namge value illa, so badalagi namge d by 4 anta ide, ee d by 4 na nanu hagene illi substitute maadkondidini. Next into I, m into I, m agide I, so I is nothing but 0.002. so ee 0.002 na hage substitute maadkondo, I can solve this equation by squaring both sides in order to find out d. So solving for d, I get d equal to 0.553 meters or 553 millimeters as diameter of the pipe. So we have to solve this equation in order to get the value of d as 553 millimeters. Now let us move our discussion into minor energy losses. So we have seen the major energy losses, that is the major energy loss is only because of friction. So friction loss is the major energy loss. Next we'll see the minor energy losses. Minor energy losses andre the losses which can be neglected. So the minor adu adra effect tumba kadime iruva kadime irodrinda adana navu minor energy losses ant heli karitivi. So minor energy losses nalli bere bere karanagalinda energy losses agutte, idanna ellanu navu minor energy losses ant heli karitivi. So ee minor energy loss agodakke karanagalna nodi, the reasons are the sudden enlargement of the pipe, loss of head due to sudden enlargement. Sudden enlargement ant helidre, let us consider a pipe in which there is a fluid flowing, the pipe diameter is d. ಈ ಡಿ ಡಯಾಮೀಟರ್ ಪೈಪ್ ನಲ್ಲಿ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇರುವಂತಹ ಫ್ಲೋ ಈಗ ಸಡನ್ಲಿ ದ ಡಯಾಮೀಟರ್ ಅಬ್ರಪ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಚೇಂಜ್ ಆಯಿತು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ, ಸಪೋಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಡಿ, ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ವೇರ್ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಡಿ ಇಸ್ ಗ್ರೇಟರ್ ದೆನ್ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಡಿ. ಸೊ ಈ ಡಯಾಮೀಟರ್ ಅಬ್ರಪ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಎನ್ಲಾರ್ಜ್ ಆಯಿತು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ, ದೇರ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ರೀಜನ್ ಸಮ್ ಲಾಸಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಅಕರ್. ದೋಸ್ ಲಾಸಸ್ ಆರ್ ಡ್ಯೂ ಟು the sudden enlargement, and they are minor losses compared to the length of the pipe, because over a length, over a period of time during the flow through the considerably larger length of the pipe, they get nullified. But pipes shorter agidaga they also form major energy losses. Next, because of sudden contraction, exactly reverse of this, consider the flow is taking place in this direction, reverse nalli iga flow aagta ide ankolana, one pipe nalli capital D is the diameter of the pipe, ಈ ಪೈಪ್ ನಲ್ಲಿ ಫ್ಲೋ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ಫ್ರಮ್ ರೈಟ್ ಟು ಲೆಫ್ಟ್. ಸೊ ಡ್ಯೂರಿಂಗ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕೋರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಈ ದೊಡ್ಡ ಡಯಾಮೀಟರ್ ನಲ್ಲಿ ಇರುವಂತಹ ಪೈಪ್ ಫ್ಲೋ ಈ ಸಣ್ಣ ಡಯಾಮೀಟರ್ ಇರುವಂತಹ ಪೈಪ್ ನಲ್ಲಿ ಹೋಗ್ಬೇಕು. ಸೊ ಇಮ್ಯಾಜಿನ್, ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಲಾರ್ಜರ್ ಫ್ಲೋ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಟು ಎಂಟರ್ ದಿ ಸ್ಮಾಲರ್ ಪೈಪ್. ಸೊ ಡ್ಯೂರಿಂಗ್ ದಿಸ್, ಇದನ್ನ ನಾವು ಬಾಟಲ್ ನೆಕ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ಕರಿತೀವಿ. ಸೊ ದ ಲಾರ್ಜರ್ flow has to be fed into the larger mouthpiece or the large shorter diameter pipe. So in this case also some losses occurs at this junction, so they are termed as losses because of sudden contraction. So next is the losses at the entrance of the pipe. So when fluid enters the pipe, let us consider a pipe. So when the fluid enters this pipe, so how does a fluid enters a pipe? So ಈ ಒಂದು ಪೈಪ್ಗೆ ಫ್ಲೂಯಿಡ್ ಎಂಟರ್ ಆಗ್ಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ದೇರ್ ಮೇ ಬಿ ವೇರಿಯಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ಸ್. ಒಂದು ಟ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ನಿಂದ ಫ್ಲೂಯಿಡ್ ಪೈಪ್ಗೆ ಎಂಟರ್ ಆಗೋ ಉದಾಹರಣೆ ತಗೊಳ್ಳೋಣ. ಸೊ ಈ ಟ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ನಿಂದ ಫ್ಲೂಯಿಡ್ ಪೈಪ್ಗೆ ಎಂಟರ್ ಆಗ್ಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ, ಸೊ ಡಿಪೆಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಆನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಏರಿಯಾ ಜಂಕ್ಷನ್ ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ losses that occur at this junction depending on this area. So area ಎಷ್ಟು ಸ್ಮೂತ್ ಆಗಿದೆ, ಎಷ್ಟು ಗ್ರಾಜುವಲ್ ಆಗಿ ನೀರು ರಿಸರ್ವಾಯರ್ ಇಂದ ಪೈಪ್ ಗೆ ಎಂಟರ್ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ಅಥವಾ ಟ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಗೆ ಎಂಟರ್ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ಅನ್ನೋದ್ರ ಮೇಲೆ. ಸೊ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಲಾಸಸ್, ಆಲ್ ದೀಸ್ ಲಾಸಸ್ ಆರ್ ಫೌಂಡ್ ಔಟ್ ಎಂಪಿರಿಕಲಿ. ಸೊ ಇದನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ಡಿಪೆಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಆನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಏರಿಯಾ, ಸೊ ಚಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಮುಖಾಂತರ ನಾವು ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಫೈಂಡ್ ಔಟ್ ದಿ ಲಾಸ್ ಕೋಎಫಿಷಿಯೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ದಿ ಲಾಸಸ್ ದಟ್ ಅಕರ್ ಅಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಜಂಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಅಟ್ ದಿ ಎಕ್ಸಿಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಪೈಪ್. ಸೊ ವೆನ್ ವಿ ಸೇ ಎಕ್ಸಿಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಪೈಪ್, ಇಮ್ಯಾಜಿನ್ ದ ಫ್ಲೋ ಇಸ್ ಕಮಿಂಗ್ ಔಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಪೈಪ್ ಟ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಅಥವಾ ರಿಸರ್ವಾಯರ್ ನಿಂದ ಫ್ಲೂಯಿಡ್ ಪೈಪ್ ಬರ್ತಾ ಇದೆ, ಪೈಪ್ ನಿಂದ ಆಚೆ ಬಂದು. ಸೊ ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಸೇ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಎಂಟರಿಂಗ್ ಒನ್ ಮೋರ್ ರಿಸರ್ವಾಯರ್ ಅನ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋಣ, ಇದು ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ರಿಸರ್ವಾಯರ್ ನ ಎಂಟರ್ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ಅಥವಾ ಟ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ನ ಎಂಟರ್ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ಅಥವಾ ಅದಲ್ಲದೆ ಅಟ್ಮಾಸ್ಫಿಯರ್ ಅಲ್ಲೇ ಬಂದು ಡಿಸ್ಚಾರ್ಜ್ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ಅನ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋಣ. ಸೊ ಇನ್ ವಾಟ್ ಎವರ್ ಕೇಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್, ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಸಮ್ ಲಾಸಸ್ ದಟ್ ಅಕರ್ ಅಟ್ ದಿ ಎಕ್ಸಿಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಪೈಪ್. ಸೊ ದೇ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಟ್ರೈಸ್ ಟು ರೆಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ದಿ ಹೆಡ್ ಆರ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಫ್ಲೋ. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಸೆಕ್ಷನ್. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್, ಲಾಸ್ ಡ್ಯೂ ಟು ಅಬ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಷನ್ ಇನ್ ಅ ಪೈಪ್. ಸೊ ಲಾಸ್ ಡ್ಯೂ ಟು ಅಬ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಷನ್ ಇನ್ ಅ ಪೈಪ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ, ಫ್ಲೂಯಿಡ್ ಫ್ಲೋ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇರುವಂತಹ ಪೈಪ್ ನಲ್ಲಿ ದೇರ್ ಮೇ ಬಿ ಅನ್ ಅಬ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಷನ್, ಒಂದು ಫಾರಿನ್ ಮೆಟೀರಿಯಲ್ ಆಗಿರ್ಬೋದು ಇಲ್ಲ ಇನ್ನೇನೋ ಆಗಿರ್ಬೋದು, ಒಂದು ಅಬ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಷನ್ ಇರ್ಬೋದು. ಈ ಅಬ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಷನ್ ಇಂದ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಫ್ಲೂಯಿಡ್ ಫ್ಲೋ ಡಿಸ್ಟರ್ಬ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಈ ಡಿಸ್ಟರ್ಬ್ ಆಗೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಲೂಸಸ್ ಸಮ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ. ಬಟ್ ಒನ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಡಿಸ್ಟರ್ಬ್ಡ್ ಕನ್ಸಿಡರಬಲ್ ಲೆಂತ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಅದು ಮತ್ತೆ ಮುಂದೆ ಹೋಗ್ಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ದಿಸ್ ಡಿಸ್ಟರ್ಬೆನ್ಸಸ್ ಗೆಟ್ಸ್ ನಲ್ಲಿಫೈಡ್, ಇದೆಲ್ಲ ಈ ಎಫೆಕ್ಟ್ ನಲ್ಲಿಫೈ ಆಗೋಗುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಬಟ್ ಅಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಜಂಕ್ಷನ್ ಸಮ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಆರ್ ಹೆಡ್ ಇಸ್ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಬೈ ದಿ ಫ್ಲೂಯಿಡ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಅಬ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಷನ್. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದಿ ಅಬ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಷನ್. ಅಬ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಷನ್ ಒಂದು ಮೆಟೀರಿಯಲ್ ಆಗಾದ್ರೂ ಇರ್ಬೋದು ಅಥವಾ ಬ್ಲಾಕೇಜ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಪೈಪ್, ಒಂದು ಪೈಪ್ ನಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದು ಬ್ಲಾಕೇಜ್, ಫೌಲಿಂಗ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ಕರಿತೀವಿ ಪೈಪ್ಸ್ ನಲ್ಲಿ ಆಗುವಂತಹ ಬ್ಲಾಕೇಜ್ ಆಗಿರ್ಬೋದು ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಸಾಲ್ಟ್ ಕಂಟೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಆಗಿರ್ಬೋದು, ಆಲ್ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಕಮಿಂಗ್ ಅಂಡರ್ ಅಬ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಷನ್ ವಿತ್ ಇನ್ ಎ ಪೈಪ್. ಸೊ ಈ ಬ್ಲಾಕೇಜ್ ಗಳಿಂದ ಪೈಪ್ ನಲ್ಲಿ ಫ್ಲೋ ಏರಿಯಾ ರೆಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ರೆಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಆಗೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಇಟ್ ಲೀಡ್ಸ್ ಟು ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಲಾಸ್ ಆರ್ ಹೆಡ್ ಲಾಸ್. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ಡ್ ಅಂಡರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಸೆಕ್ಷನ್. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್, ಡ್ಯೂ ಟು ಪೈಪ್ ಬೆಂಡ್. ಸೊ ಪೈಪ್ ನಲ್ಲಿ ಇರುವಂತಹ ಬೆಂಡ್, ವೆನ್ ವಿ ಕನೆಕ್ಟ್ ಟೂ ಪೈಪ್ಸ್ ಅಟ್ ಅನ್ ಆಂಗಲ್, ಸೊ ವಿ ಯೂಸ್ ಬೆಂಡ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಎರಡು ಪೈಪ್ ನ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಆಂಗಲ್ಸ್ ನಲ್ಲಿ ಕನೆಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ಬೆಂಡ್ ನ ಬಳಸ್ತೀವಿ. ಬೆಂಡ್ಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಆಂಗಲ್ಸ್, ಬೇರೆ ಬೇರೆ ಆಂಗಲ್ ನಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ಬೆಂಡ್ಸ್ ನ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ. ಸೊ ಡಿಪೆಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಆನ್ ದಿ ಆಂಗಲ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಬೆಂಡ್, ರೇಡಿಯಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಕರ್ವೇಚರ್ ಎಕ್ಸೆಟ್ರಾ, ಸೊ ದೀಸ್ ಬೆಂಡ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಕನ್ಸ್ಯೂಮ್ ಸಮ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದಿ ಫ್ಲೋ. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಕಮ್ ಅಂಡರ್ ದ ಲಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಹೆಡ್ ಡ್ಯೂ ಟು ಪೈಪ್ ಬೆಂಡ್. ಸೊ ಹೆಡ್ ಡ್ಯೂ ಟು ಪೈಪ್ ಫಿಟ್ಟಿಂಗ್ಸ್, ಸೊ ಪೈಪ್ ನಲ್ಲಿ ವೇರಿಯಸ್ ಟೈಪ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಫಿಟ್ಟಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ, ಆ ಫಿಟ್ಟಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಕೂಡ ಸಮ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದಿ ಫ್ಲೂಯಿಡ್ ಫ್ಲೋ ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ಅವೇ. ಸೊ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸಿಫೈಡ್ ಅಂಡರ್ ಲಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಹೆಡ್ ಡ್ಯೂ ಟು ಪೈಪ್ ಫಿಟ್ಟಿಂಗ್ಸ್. ಎಷ್ಟಕ್ಕೆಷ್ಟು ಪೈಪ್ ಫಿಟ್ಟಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ನ ಬಳಸ್ತೀವೋ ನಾವು, ಸೊ ಅಷ್ಟಕ್ಕಷ್ಟು ನಮಗೆ ಲಾಸಸ್ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಎಷ್ಟಕ್ಕೆಷ್ಟು ಪೈಪ್ಸ್ ಬೆಂಡ್ ಆಗತ್ತೆ, ಬೆಂಡ್ಸ್ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಿರ್ತೀವೋ ಅಷ್ಟಕ್ಕಷ್ಟು ನಮಗೆ ಹೆಡ್ ಕಡಿಮೆ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಹೋಗುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್, ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಸಿ ದಿ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೈನರ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಲಾಸ್. ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೈನರ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಲಾಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಡ್ಯೂ ಟು ಸಡನ್ ಎನ್ಲಾರ್ಜ್ಮೆಂಟ್. ಸೊ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸೀನ್ ದಟ್ ವೆನ್ ದಿ ಫ್ಲೋ is through a pipe of diameter d, the diameter d nalli aagta iruvanta flow at a velocity v1, let us say fluid is flowing, when the diameter changes abruptly, ondu sanna pipe ninda flow innondu dodda pipe ge hogbekadre what exactly happens. So you can have a look at here. So sanna pipe nalli aagta iruvanta flow ee dodda pipe nalli serbeku ant helidre it cannot follow the path immediately, curve ಎಂಟರ್ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಂಗೆನೆ ಈ ಪೈಪ್ ನ ಅದು ಫುಲ್ ಆಗಿ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ಆಗಿ ತುಂಬೋಕೆ ಸಾಧ್ಯ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ವೆನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕೆನಾಟ್ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ಲಿ ಫಿಲ್ ದಿ ಪೈಪ್, ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಫಾಲೋಸ್ ಎ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಪಾತ್. ದೇರ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸಿ ಹಿಯರ್ ಇಟ್ ಫಾಲೋಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪಾತ್. ಸೊ ಈ ಪಾತ್ ಫ್ಲೂಯಿಡ್ ಈ ಪಾತ್ ನ ತಗೊಳ್ಳೋದ್ರಿಂದ, ಸೊ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಅಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಜಂಕ್ಷನ್ ಎಡೀಸ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಆಗಕ್ಕೆ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಎಡೀಸ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಆಗಕ್ಕೆ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಆದಾಗ, ಸೊ ವಿ ನೋ ವೆನ್ ಎಡೀಸ್ ಫಾರ್ಮೇಶನ್ ಅಕರ್ಸ್, the fluid molecules will try to interact with each other by transfer of momentum or energy, so thereby resulting in higher friction. Friction jaasti aagta ide illi because of transfer of momentum, so hence friction jaasti aadange, so we are there occurs some losses. These losses can be quantified using the equation v1 square minus v2 square divided by 2g. So here we can see the smaller pipe feeding the larger pipe. The flow is not able to follow the abrupt change in the diameter, hence it takes this path, results in eddy formation. Eddy formation in the friction jasti aagi, friction in the energy losses jasti agutte. So consider two sections. First section bandu pipe 1 nallide, second section bandu pipe 2 nallide. So adu pipe 2 nalli naavu elli ittidivi anta helidre section 2 na, when the flow occupies the complete area of the flow. So when we call this as a fully developed region anta heli karithivi. So ee region na navu hydrodynamic entry region anta heli karithivi. This is not a fully developed flow. This is hydrodynamic entry region, but whereas this is a fully developed flow. So illige illinda illige barodrolage the fluid has occupied the entire pipe. So this is hydrodynamic entry region or not a fully developed region. This is a fully developed region. Section 2 na now fully developed region al tagondidivi. Section 1 of the bandu pipe 1 alli tagondidivi. So when we apply Bernoulli's equation at the section 1 and 2, so we'll be able to arrive at this equation, that is v1 minus v2 the whole square divided by 2g. So where v1 is the velocity of the flow at section 1 and v2 is the velocity of flow at section 2. So similarly, P1 and P2 are pressure at section 1 and 2 respectively. Area A1 and A2 are the area of the pipe cross section at section 1 and 2. So we are not interested in the derivation part of the equation. So the equation to find out the head loss due to sudden enlargement is given here. So we can directly remember this equation as difference in velocity the whole square divided by 2g. So next, coming to sudden contraction, see the exact reverse of this. So here the fluid is traveling from left to right, so from smaller diameter pipe to a larger diameter pipe. So whereas in the sudden contraction, when sudden contraction takes place, see the fluid takes a different path. There you can observe here, so from a larger diameter pipe to a smaller diameter pipe. So when the fluid enters from larger diameter to smaller diameter, it leads to formation of vena contracta. So because of this low pressure vena contracta, a low pressure region, so here you can see after this vena contracta section CC, it is same as the sudden expansion. See, illi navu nodabodu ondu larger diameter pipe inda smaller diameter ge pipe flow fluid flow aagbekadre the flow follows this region. Flow sanna diameter pipe enter agodikinta munche leads to formation of vena contracta. Ee vena contracta bage naavu sufficient agi kalthirthivi. So because of this formation of vena contracta, again the fluid starts filling the pipe once again. So ee vena contracta inda ee section 2, see we have considered section 1 here and section 2 here. So in between this we have section CC called as vena contracta region. So ee section in the section 2 ke flow hogbekadre we can observe here it is again similar to this condition, that is smaller section in the larger section ke flow hoguva condition ge naavu matte bartta idivi. So here the flow travels from the smaller section to the larger section once again, resulting in formation of eddies. So this eddies will take away some amount of energy from the fluid flow, so hence resulting in or contributing in loss of head given by the equation 0.5 divided by v2 0.5 into v2 square divided by 2g. So v2 is velocity of flow in a pipe, velocity of flow or a mean velocity of flow in a pipe, and we know that 2 into g is acceleration due to gravity. So the loss of head due to sudden contraction can be estimated by the formula 0.5 into v2 square divided by 2g. So next, loss of head at the entrance of the pipe. So we have seen the loss of energy because of sudden enlargement and sudden contraction. So now we'll see the loss of head at the entrance of the pipe. So entrance, when we say entrance, before the fluid enters the pipe, it has to enter either from a reservoir or a tank. So in the tank athwa reservoir nindane flow pipe ge baroke sadhya. So ee tank athwa reservoir or directly from a tank, let us say the fluid enters the pipe, enter aguvaga, so depending on this junction, so pipe bandu yava riti tank ge connect agide annodr mele we can estimate the loss. So when the flow starts entering when the flow starts entering the reservoir from reservoir to the tank, the flow cannot completely occupy the pipe immediately. It results like this, and there the fluid start occupying the entire pipe region. So here we lose sufficient amount of energy. So depending on the way in which the pipe is attached to the tank. So illi navu junction yav riti ide andre pipe yav riti tank ge connect agide anno aadharada mele we can estimate the loss, that is given by k into v square divided by 2g. So k is a coefficient which can be found out from the design or the design of attachment of the pipe to a reservoir. So where v is the velocity of the flow within a pipe in meters per second, g is acceleration due to gravity. So k is a coefficient which depends on this junction. Let us take few examples here. So I already told you k is a coefficient which depends on the way in which the pipe is connected to the tank. So here we are considering a simple case where the pipe sharp corner is connected to the tank. The sharp corner of the pipe is directly connected to the tank. So there may be cases where this sharp corner, this 90 degree corner, can be rounded off in order to smooth out the flow. So it is to radius generous agi idiyo astukashtu flow smooth agutte, losses kadime agutte. So losses yava case nalli jaasti irutte anta helidre yavaga the pipe is connected exactly with this sharp corner. The sharp corner iddashtu ee flow na disturb madutte, ee reservoir ninda baruvantha fluid ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಈ ಪೈಪ್ ಫುಲ್ಲಿ ಡೆವಲಪ್ಡ್ ರೀಜನ್ ಆಗೋದಕ್ಕೆ ಸುಮಾರು ಸಮಯ ತಗೊಳ್ಳುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಅದರಿಂದ ಲಾಸಸ್ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಈ ಲಾಸಸ್ ನ ಕಡಿಮೆ ಮಾಡೋಕೆ, ಸೊ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಚೇಂಜ್ ದಿ ಶಾರ್ಪ್ ಕಾರ್ನರ್ ಹಿಯರ್. ಈ ಶಾರ್ಪ್ ಕಾರ್ನರ್ ನಾವು ಎಷ್ಟಕ್ಕೆಷ್ಟು ಸ್ಮೂತ್ ಔಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವೋ ಅಷ್ಟಕ್ಕಷ್ಟು ನಮಗೆ ಲಾಸಸ್ ಕಡಿಮೆ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಶಾರ್ಪ್ ಕಾರ್ನರ್ ಈ ಒಂದು ಅಟ್ಯಾಚ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಗೆ ತಕ್ಕಂತೆ ಕೆ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಬದಲಾಗ್ತಾ ಹೋಗುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಕೆ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಯಾವ ರೀತಿ ಬದಲಾಗುತ್ತೆ ನೋಡಿ. ಸೊ ಇಯರ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಸೆಕ್ಷನ್ ರಿಎಂಟ್ರೆಂಟ್ ರೀಜನ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ಕರಿತೀವಿ. ಸೊ ವೇರ್ ದಿ ಪೈಪ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಬೀನ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟೆಂಡೆಡ್ ಆರ್ ಸಫಿಷಿಯಂಟ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರೊಟ್ರೂಡೆಡ್ ವಿತಿನ್ ದಿ ಟ್ಯಾಂಕ್. ಒಂದು ಪೈಪ್ ನ ಟ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಜಂಕ್ಷನ್ ಹತ್ರನೇ ಇಲ್ಲದೆ ಸಫಿಷಿಯಂಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಒಳಗಡೆ ತಳ್ಳಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಸೊ ಈ ತಳ್ಳಿರೋದ್ರಿಂದ ನೋಡಿ ಫ್ಲೂಯಿಡ್ ಫಾಲೋ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇರುವಂತಹ ಪಾತ್ ನ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವ್ ಹಿಯರ್. ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ಸಫಿಷಿಯಂಟ್ಲಿ longer time to enter the region, hence k equal to 0.8. the losses are more here. So whereas coming to our sharp edged, simple case of sharp edged entrance region, so where the losses k equal to 0.5, so we can substitute 0.5 in place of k here. So in sulp around, when I give a sufficient radius at this junction, the slightly rounded section, k equal to 0.2, inno kadme agutte, losses will reduce much lesser. Next, well rounded. So when the radius is sufficiently generous, ati hechada radius na kottaga smooth edge na nanu ile provide madadaga, the losses are very very less. Here you can observe the k value is 0.04. the k value turns out to be 0.04 depending on the type of the attachment. So for all general cases we assume that k equal to 0.5, because we assume that the pipe has been attached to the reservoir with its sharp edge only, without any bend or radius. So hence we take the losses at the inlet of the pipe, that is when flow starts from reservoir to the pipe, the loss is 0.5 into v square divided by 2g. So v is mean velocity in the pipe flow in meters per second. So next type of energy loss, minor losses at the exit of the pipe. So exit of the pipe, so we all know the flow at one point or the other has to come out of the pipe flow. So because the fluid has to enter the desired region, ondalla ondu jagadalli a flow anadu athwa fluid anadu a pipe na bit aache barutte. Aache baruvanta fluid ondu innondu reservoir ge hogabodu, or innondu reservoir athwa tank ge hogi serabodu, athwa just direct agi atmosphere ge hogi serabodu, coming into directly into atmosphere. Yavade case adru kuda there occur some loss. What type of loss? See, when the fluid is within the pipe, it has kinetic energy or kinetic head given by v square by 2g. So at this point when the fluid is discharged to the next reservoir or to any stream or to an open channel, it is assumed that it is losing its complete kinetic energy that is given by V square by 2G. So the losses that occurs at the exit of the pipe is given by HE, that is head loss at the exit, is equal to V square divided by 2G. So V is nothing but the velocity of flow, mean velocity of flow within the pipe. Next, the losses that occur because of bend. So we know where exactly the bends are used. Bends anodu common agi we use in many places. Namma water taps nallu kuda we use bends. So most common is the L bend at 90 degrees. So idu navu ellaru nodirthivi. So this is called as a bend. So bend anadu 90 degree le irbeku anta illa. So it can be of any angle. So it can be of any angle, any radius of curvature. A simple 90 degree bend ne, so we can give it generously. For example, you can look at it. So this is a simple 90 degree bend. So here the only difference is the radius of curvature. The radius of curvature is different. So I have given a generous radius, but whereas in this shorter L bend, the radius of curvature is very lesser. So here the radius of curvature is more. So depending on this radius of curvature, the angle of the bend and the diameter of the pipe, so we have a bend coefficient calculated. Suppose for example fluid is flowing within this pipe, so and because of the bend it loses some amount of energy. This bend anadu swalpa amount of energy na reduce madutte. So this reduce madadu is given by k into v square divided by 2g. V anadu, v is the velocity of flow within the pipe, so it is given by k into v square divided by 2g. So k anadu is a bend coefficient. Ee bend na mele ee k value depend agutte. So k na decide madodu yaru, k na decide madodu the diameter of the pipe, angle of the bend and radius of the curvature. Ee mooru parameter the value of k, that is the bend coefficient, na decide martave. So here you can see simple 90 degree bend can be given in two different forms with different radius of curvature. So generous the radius is, lesser amount the loss is. So it is like that. So but we can sum up like this. So the loss of head due to pipe bend will be HB equal to k into v square divided by 2g. So v is the velocity, mean velocity of the flow within the pipe, and k is the bend coefficient that depends on the diameter of the pipe, angle of the bend, radius of the curvature. So all these things will be directly given in the problem. That is, k will be directly given in the problem. Without any worry, we can just directly substitute the value and we can find out the losses. So next, last type of losses, loss due to the pipe fittings. So there will be various types of pipe fittings. So here a few cases are shown here. So this are the components or pipe fittings used in hydraulic lines. Here you can see the thickness of the pipe that is used in hydraulic lines for high pressure application. So here we are able to see a control valve. So control valve, so T, L bend, couplings, etc. So all these are called as pipe fittings. So they are used to route the fluid to the desired location. On the particular location ge now fluid na tagond hoglikke now ee T joints, L joints, couplings idanella balustivi. So ee T joint, L joint, coupling, so flow control maduvantaha valve, so idella en madutte, it contributes towards loss of energy. Solpa amount of energy na it takes away. So all this energy loss can be found out using the equation H into PF. HPF anta helidre head loss because of pipe fittings is given by k into v square divided by 2g. So suppose for example I have a L bend here, or let us say we have a pipe and we are attaching one more pipe using a coupling here. One coupling attach madta idini. Next, during the flow I use a control valve here. This is one control valve, and next I can use a T joint here. I have used a T joint here. So this is a T joint, this is a coupling. Couplings are used in order to join two pipes of same diameter or of varying diameters, etc. This is a control valve. So ee control valve, see ella ee pipe fittings galu en maduttave, some amount of loss, energy na loss maduttave. Suppose this is at section 1, ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನಾನು ಫೈನಲ್ ಆಗಿ ಸೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಟೂ ನ ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪೈಪ್ ಫಿಟ್ಟಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ದ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಅಟ್ ದ ಸೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಒನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದಿ ಸೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಟೂ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್. ಸೊ ಡೆಫಿನೆಟ್ಲಿ ನಮಗ್ ಗೊತ್ತು ಸೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಟೂ ನಲ್ಲಿ ಇರುವಂತ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಲೆಸ್ಸರ್ ದೆನ್ ಹೆಚ್ ಒನ್. ಯಾಕಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ಹೆಚ್ ಒನ್ ಸೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಒನ್ ಇಂದ ಫ್ಲೂಯಿಡ್ ಫ್ಲೋ ಆಗ್ಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ಇದೆಲ್ಲ ಪೈಪ್ ಫಿಟ್ಟಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿನ ತಗೊಂಡ್ಬಿಡುತ್ತೆ, ಅದನ್ನೇ ನಾವು ಲಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಹೆಡ್ ಡ್ಯೂ ಟು ಪೈಪ್ ಫಿಟ್ಟಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ಕರಿತೀವಿ. ಸೊ ಈ ಲಾಸಸ್ ನ ನಾವು ಎಸ್ಟಿಮೇಟ್ ಮಾಡೋದಕ್ಕೆ ವಿ ಯೂಸ್ ದ ಈಕ್ವೇಶನ್ ಕೆ ಇಂಟು ವಿ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್ ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಬೈ ಟೂ ಜಿ. ವಿ ಇಸ್ ದಿ ಮೀನ್ ವೆಲಾಸಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಫ್ಲೋ ವಿತ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಪೈಪ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಕೆ ಇಸ್ ಎ ಕೋಎಫಿಷಿಯಂಟ್ ದಟ್ ಡಿಪೆಂಡ್ಸ್ ಆನ್ ದಿ ಟೈಪ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಫಿಟ್ಟಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಫಿಟ್ಟಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಹಿಯರ್. ಸೊ ದ ಟೈಪ್ ಈ ಯಾವ ಟೈಪ್ ನಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ಯಾವ ಟೈಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಪೈಪ್ ಫಿಟ್ಟಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಿದೀವಿ ಅನ್ನೋದ್ರ ಮೇಲೆ ದಿ ಕೋಎಫಿಷಿಯಂಟ್ ಡಿಪೆಂಡ್ಸ್. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಕೋಎಫಿಷಿಯಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಪೈಪ್ ಫಿಟ್ಟಿಂಗ್. ಸೊ ದ ರಿಮೈನಿಂಗ್ ವಿ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್ ಬೈ ಟೂ ಜಿ ಇಸ್ ಮೀನ್ ವೆಲಾಸಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಫ್ಲೋ ಅಂಡ್ ಜಿ ಇಸ್ ದಿ ಆಕ್ಸಿಲರೇಷನ್ ಡ್ಯೂ ಟು ಗ್ರಾವಿಟಿ. ಸೊ ವಿತ್ ದಿಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಏಬಲ್ ಟು ಫೈಂಡ್ ಔಟ್ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದಿ ಹೆಡ್ ಲಾಸ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಪೈಪ್ ಫಿಟ್ಟಿಂಗ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಎ ಸಿಂಪಲ್ ಲುಕ್ ಅಟ್ ಒನ್ ವರ್ಕ್ಡ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಇನ್ ಆರ್ಡರ್ ಟು ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ದಿ ಮೈನರ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಲಾಸಸ್ ವಿತ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಪೈಪ್. So consider a pipe of 60 meters long and 150 millimeters diameter is connected to a water tank. Here we are able to see a pipe of 150 mm diameter. So 150 millimeter diameter pipe is connected of 60 meters long is connected to a tank at one end and delivers water to the atmosphere. See atmosphere and helidre, so the water is let out. ಟ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ನಿಂದ ವಾಟರ್ ಆಚೆ ಹೋಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ. ದಿ ಹೈಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ವಾಟರ್ ಲೆವೆಲ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಟ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಇಸ್ 3 meters. ಹಿಯರ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಗಿವನ್ ದ ಹೈಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ವಾಟರ್ ಲೆವೆಲ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಟ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಇಸ್ 3 meters ಅಬೌವ್ ದಿ ಸೆಂಟರ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಪೈಪ್. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದಿ ಸೆಂಟರ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಪೈಪ್. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ದಿ ಡೇಟಮ್ ಆರ್ ದಿ ರೆಫರೆನ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಅಬೌವ್ ದಿ ಸೆಂಟರ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಪೈಪ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದಿ ಪೈಪ್ ಈಸ್ ಹಾರಿಜಾಂಟಲ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಟೇಕ್ ಎಫ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು 0.01. ಎಫ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ನಮಗ್ ಗೊತ್ತು ದ ಫ್ರಿಕ್ಷನ್ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಡಾರ್ಸಿಸ್ ಈಕ್ವೇಶನ್. ಸೊ ಡಿಟರ್ಮಿನ್ ದಿ ಡಿಸ್ಚಾರ್ಜ್ ಥ್ರೂ ದಿ ಪೈಪ್. ಸೊ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ದ ಡಿಸ್ಚಾರ್ಜ್ ಥ್ರೂ ದ ಪೈಪ್ ಕನ್ಸಿಡರಿಂಗ್ ಮೈನರ್ ಲಾಸಸ್. ಮೈನರ್ ಲಾಸಸ್ ನಾನು ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಂಡು ನಾವು ಡಿಸ್ಚಾರ್ಜ್ ನ ಫೈಂಡ್ ಔಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕಿರತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಏನೇನು ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಕೈಂಡ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಲಾಸಸ್ ದಟ್ ಅಕರ್. ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ಪೈಪ್ ಇದೆ. ಸೊ ಪೈಪ್ ಇದೆ, ಅದರದ ಲೆಂತ್ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ 60 meters. ಸೊ 60 meter ಲೆಂತ್ ಪೈಪ್ ಇದೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ಡೆಫಿನೆಟ್ಲಿ ದೇರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಫ್ರಿಕ್ಷನ್. ಸೊ ಫ್ರಿಕ್ಷನ್ ನ ಫೈಂಡ್ ಔಟ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು, ಲಾಸಸ್ ಡ್ಯೂ ಟು ಫ್ರಿಕ್ಷನ್ ಫೈಂಡ್ ಔಟ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟೂ ಈಕ್ವೇಶನ್, ಒನ್ ಇಸ್ ಡಾರ್ಸಿ ಈಕ್ವೇಶನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಚೆಜಿ ಈಕ್ವೇಶನ್. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಚೆಜಿ ಈಕ್ವೇಶನ್ ಹಾಕ್ಬೇಕಾ ಡಾರ್ಸಿ ಈಕ್ವೇಶನ್ ಹಾಕ್ಬೇಕಾ? ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ಚೆಜಿಸ್ ಕಾನ್ಸ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿಲ್ಲ, ಬದಲಾಗಿ ಫ್ರಿಕ್ಷನ್ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಆಫ್ ಡಾರ್ಸಿಸ್ ಈಕ್ವೇಶನ್ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಸೇಸ್ ದಟ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಯೂಸ್ ಡಾರ್ಸಿಸ್ ಈಕ್ವೇಶನ್. ಸೊ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಡಾರ್ಸಿಸ್ ಈಕ್ವೇಶನ್ ಹಿಯರ್. ಸೊ ಡಾರ್ಸಿಸ್ ಈಕ್ವೇಶನ್ ನ ಬಳಸ್ಕೋಬೇಕು, ಅದರ ಜೊತೆ ಮೈನರ್ ಲಾಸಸ್ ನಾನು ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ importantly we should consider loss anta helidre, one is friction loss that occur in the pipe and also the loss that is occurring at the inlet of the pipe. So now previous agi kaltvi reservoir ninda pipe ku hogbekadre there will be losses that occur at the entrance of the pipe. So that is given by the formula 0.5 into v square divided by 2g. Adara jothege Darcy's equation hakondre we will get the total loss, so with which we will be able to find out the discharge through the pipe. So let us see what are all the given within the problem. So given data is the diameter of the pipe is 0.15 meters. 150 millimeter I have reduced it to meters. L is the length of the pipe 60 meters, and z1 that is the elevation or the datum 3 meters, and f is friction factor 0.01. So next is the head loss to find by the Darcy's equation is given by 4 FLV square by 2 GD. So here we have a simple representation of the pipe that is attached to the reservoir where the level of the water is 3 meters. So we are considering this as section 11 and this as section 22. So the tank surface is section 11, the outlet of the pipe is section 22. Let us apply the Bernoulli's equation between the section 11 and 22. So the Bernoulli's equation is given by pressure head, kinetic head and the potential head is equal to a constant. So we are considering between section 11 and section 22. Therefore we are equating the total energy at section 1 to section 22. So the total energy at section 11 is given by p1 by rho g plus v1 square by 2g plus z1 equal to p2 by rho g plus v2 square by 2g plus z2 plus losses. So we can see here directly the energy at section 1 is equal to energy at section 2 plus some amount of losses. So therefore the left hand side and right hand side are equal by the term losses. When we add the loss to this energy at section 2 so they become equal. So substituting in the Bernoulli's equation, see here, at the surface of the tank the pressure is atmospheric, hence the pressure head turns to be zero, and the velocity or the kinetic head at the section 1-1 is also zero, because we are assuming the reservoir to be infinite, and the change in velocity compared to its dimensions or the change in the water surface is negligible, hence we are considering it as zero. Next, the height of or the datum head above the center of the pipe is 3 millimeters. This is the reference that we have considered. From here the z1 is 3 meters, again that equal to pressure at the outlet section 2 pressure at the outlet is zero plus v2 square is the velocity or the kinetic head at the section 2 plus z2 here it is coinciding with the center of the pipe, hence it is zero plus the losses. So now we are equating this to get 3 equal to v2 square by 2g plus losses. This v2 is directly written as v here. So considering the minor losses, that is at the inlet and exit of the pipe, so here we are considering the minor losses as the losses that occur at the inlet of the pipe and the losses that occur at the within the, that is the friction losses that occur within the pipe. So here in the equation we get the inlet losses are given by 0.5 into v square divided by 2g, and the losses because of friction by Darcy's equation is given 4f lv square by 2gd. So here the hf, that is 3 meter head of water into v square by 2g, is taken as a common factor here, so this results in 1 plus 0.5 into 4fl by d. So on substituting all the terms, so we get the value of v to be 1.83 meters per second. So knowing the value, we know the diameter or area of the pipe, so with this we can calculate the discharge of the equation that is required. So q is equal to a into v, so area can be calculated by pi by 4 d square into velocity, so with this we'll be able to calculate the discharge as 0.0324 meter cubes per second. To convert this into liters per second, we are multiplying this by 1000, so this will result to 32.40 liters per second. So the next worked example, an horizontal pipeline of 30 meters long is connected to the water tank at one end and delivers water into the atmosphere at other end. For the first 25 meters of its length from the tank, the pipe is 150 mm diameter, and its diameter is suddenly enlarged to 300 millimeters. The height of the water level in the tank is 8 meters above the center of the pipe. Take f equal to 0.01 for both sections of the pipe. Determine the discharge through the pipe considering the minor losses also. So here also we have to consider the minor losses. So here we can calculate the head loss by two equations, Darcy and Chizzy equation. So here particularly f is given, so it is understood that we have to calculate the head loss using Darcy's equation. So here the problem is slightly different. So here the length of the pipe is 40 meters, but the entire section of the pipe is not of same diameter. Here it is said that the first 25 meter of the pipe is, length of the pipe is 150 mm in diameter. In 40 millimeter nalli modala 25 bandu diameter is 150. In 40 meter nalli modala 25 meter a different diameter irutte, that is 150 mm diameter, and the remaining is 300 mm diameter. So here in 40 nalli modala 25 bandu bere diameter agide, nantarada 25 is, sorry, nantarada remaining 15 is of a different diameter. So this is 15, this is 25, so the diameter is 150 mm here, so this is 300 mm here. So a large reservoir is supplying fluid into this, so the fluid is supplied to this pipe from the reservoir. So here once again we can consider the Bernoulli's equation applied between section 1, that is the surface of the water within the tank, and the outlet of the pipe, that is the section 2. So applying Bernoulli's equation, we'll be able to find out the loss of head and hence the discharge through the pipe. So let us see what are all the given parameters in the problem. So here the diameter 1, that is up to 25 meter length, is 0.15 meter, and D2 diameter 2 for the remaining 15 meters is 0.3 meters, and the total length of the pipe is 40 meters. So Z1, that is the level of water within the tank, is 8 meters, and F is equal to 0.01. So here we are calculating the loss of head using Darcy's equation. So here we have the sketch. It shows the surface of the water 8 meter above the center of the pipe, that is the datum, and the pipes the pipe changes in diameter up to 25 meters in length, diameter is 0.15 meters, and the remaining 15 meters, the diameter changes to 0.3 meters. So applying Bernoulli's equation between the pipe surface, so this is the section 1 and this is the section 2. So we are applying the Bernoulli's equation between the section 1-1 and section 2-2. So we get the pressure head, kinetic head, and the datum head. So we have the pressure head to be zero because this is exposed to atmosphere. So again, the velocity or the kinetic head is zero because the rate of change, this, the change of the surface is infinite, hence it is considered to be zero. Next is datum, Z 8 meters, the surface of the water is 8 meter above the center line of the pipe, hence it is taken as 8. So next is pressure head at the section 2. So the outlet of the pipe is exposed to atmosphere, hence these two get cancelled, that is they are taken as 0, plus V2 square, that is the velocity of the flow at section 2. So next Z2 is the datum, it is coinciding with the datum or the reference line, hence taken as 0, plus losses. So what are the different types of losses? So the losses that occur here, is, see, from a large reservoir the fluid is entering a pipe, so this is the loss at the inlet section. Next, the fluid flows through the pipe, hence it undergoes the frictional losses in pipe 1. Next, the area of the pipe is changing suddenly, the smaller pipe is feeding the larger pipe, hence we get the larger we get a loss because of the sudden enlargement of the pipe, HE, and again the pipe flows within this 15 meter pipe, it undergoes friction, hence the loss HF2. So HF1, HF2 can be calculated using Darcy's equation, and HI and HE, we know the formula that we can substitute directly here. So we can see the losses equated here. So HI, inlet loss, friction in the pipe 1 because of enlargement, head loss because of enlargement in the pipe, and next is the loss of friction in the second pipe. So substituting all the values, so we get an equation like this. So here there are two unknowns, velocity 1 and velocity 2. So we know that from continuity equation, that is A1 V1 equal to A2 V2. So with this we can substitute V1, we can calculate V1 in terms of V2. So V1 na navu V2 in terms of V2 find out maadkoltivi. So it comes up to, when we substitute the values for the diameter here, so we get V1 to be 4 times V2. So V1 bandu V2 na 4 krashtu ide. So ee V1 value na navu ee equation nalle substitute maadadaga, so we get the value of V2 to be 1.113 meters per second. So we know the value of V2, so you can try this. So substitute the value of V1 in terms of V2 here. So the only unknown will be V2 in this equation. Substitute all the values of F, L, D, etc., and you'll finally get the value of V2 as 1.113 meters per second. And next last thing that we need is the discharge. We have to calculate the discharge value, hence discharge can be calculated using the equation Q is equal to A2 into V2. So we know the A2, pi by 4 into D2 square into V2, that will give us pi by 4 into 0.3 whole square into the velocity. So we'll get the discharge to be 78.67 liters per second. The last simple concept. So next we move our discussion to hydraulic and total gradient line. So hydraulic gradient line, so is defined as a line which represent sum of pressure head, kinetic head, and the datum head. See, when we say hydraulic, see, consider flow through a pipe, the fluid is flowing through a pipe. So if we consider different sections, section 1, 2, 3, 4, etc., and if we measure the head over there, so head in the sense the total head, the total energy is given by the Bernoulli's equation as the pressure head, kinetic head, plus potential head is constant. So we have to considering the sum of all these things, see, potential head, kinetic head and the datum head, that is P by rho g, V square by 2g and z. So if we consider at each and individual sections, the energy at section 1, total energy at section 1, total energy at section 2, total energy at section 3. And if we plot a line through all these points, we get a line like this, which is called as the total gradient line. So it is a line which represents sum of pressure head, kinetic head and the datum head over the length of flow. See, it is representing all these heads over the length of flow. See, consider pipe flow. When I plot all these heads during the flow, I'll get a line like this over a length of flow. This is called as the total gradient line. When I plot energy versus the length of the pipe, I'll get a line like this. So this is called as the total gradient line. So this represents the sum of all the forms of energy and this will have a downward slope. This downward slope yen helta ide, see, section 1 ninda hidu neevu consider madironta nth section, last section tanaka the energy of the fluid is reducing because of various kinds of losses. Gradient line anodo will always slope downwards, it will not slope upwards until and unless you supply some external energy. So ee total gradient line anodo constant agu irodilla, yeru mukkadallu kuda irodilla, idu yavaglu down, it has a downward slope because the energy goes on reducing. Suppose idanna nanu steady agi maintain madbeku athava ond yeru gati pragatiyalli idbeku ant helidre nan en madbeku, I have to supply an external energy from a pump or a blower in order to maintain the energy or increase the amount of energy into the fluid. So this external energy supply madilla annadadre the total energy line will have a downward slope only. So next, hydraulic gradient line. So this is also similar to this. Hydraulic gradient line ant helidre a line that represent the sum of pressure head and the datum z only. Here total energy line alli it was sum of all forms of energy. Hydraulic gradient line alli it is only the pressure head and the datum head. Illi now kinetic head na consider maartta illa. So during the flow of the pipe, if we consider the piezometric head, piezometric head andre sum of pressure head and the datum head only. Ee eradunu kuda nanu different sections of the pipe nalli tagolta hodre, so I'll get a line which represent the hydraulic gradient line. So this will be the total gradient line. This is the hydraulic gradient line. So this is the flow in a pipe. See, pratiyondu section 1 2 3 whatever the sections you consider martiro allella kuda energy of the fluid or rate of the fluid will slowly start reducing. So total energy line, hydraulic energy line graphically idana illustrate maartta irutave over the length of the time. So total energy line sada mele irutte, hydraulic energy line kelage irutte. Yake, so what is the difference between them? The difference between them is the kinetic head, that is V square divided by 2g. Kinetic head yavaglu ivaradru madhya vyathyasavage irutte. So total energy line has sum of all the energies and hydraulic energy line has only the piezometric head. Piezometric head ant helidre P by rho g and z. So P by rho g plus z madadaga namge sigontha points nalla nav line join madadaga we get an hydraulic gradient line. And total energy, total gradient line has sum of all forms of energy, pressure energy, kinetic energy and datum head also, that is potential head. So thank you all, any questions?